International Buddhist Relief Organization, you have the floor.
Mr. President, at this UPR, let me please draw the attention of the Council to the heinous act of violence committed by the world's most ruthless terrorist organization that operated in Sri Lanka for some 30 years with total impunity. They still continue these terror tactics through the dubious vile propaganda to mislead the global community, project them as a civilized group that never terrorized Sri Lankan in general and Tamils in particular. Having failed to achieve these targets through the means of terror, now they are engaged in extensive propaganda campaign worldwide with funds forcibly extracted from the Tamil refugees and Islam seekers in Europe and North America. Let us hope Human Rights Council will not be deceived by the cowardly act of the LTT rams. On the other hand, there is an element of total discredit, absolute silence on the part of the Council. When the LTT was operating at its zenith, they were killing innocent civilians in thousands. They decimated political and religious leaders. Historical religious places were bombed and destroyed during this period. We had only deafening silence of the part of the International Committee and this Council. It is ironic that neither UNHRC expert nor Mr. Ban Ki-moon private team bothered to examine very authoritative and analytical report prepared by the world-renowned war crime expert Sir Donald Silva. Meeting with the convicted LTT terrorist, Mr. Emerson, already violated the UN mandate. We strongly condemn the double standard of the Council. My earnest request, Mr. President, for the Commissioner and the Council to remain fair, just impartial and neutral, instead of being led by a small group of expatriate Tamil who live in contribution received from the poor Tamils.
Gracias.